Today, I am going to be catfishing the river here. We have a dam here in Lawrence, Kansas. I've seen some pretty fucking big fish pulled out of here. I'm talking 45-pounders, 60-pounders. I've even seen videos of an 80-pounder of a friend that I work with. I have some live bluegill for bait. There's only two of them. I spent the last hour trying to catch bluegill. I forgot how fucking hard it was. I've been too busy catching these big-ass fish. Forgot how to fucking jig a jig. I have new braided line on my river rig. My Black Max open face reels set up to be a river rig as well. I also got some raw chicken. So let's get down there. Let's get set up and let's fucking catch some. Yeah. Baby bet, hey, couple X, hey, couple Grammys on him, couple plaques, hey, that's a fact, hey, throw it back, hey, throw it back, hey. Alright, you guys, this is the river. You can see the dam up there. There are a couple other people fishing here. I'm not too sure how they're gonna feel about it. Honestly, I don't give a motherfuck. And if they got a problem, you know I keep that thing on me. My river rig is Abu Garcia BCX 6600 Ambassador with a bait clicker. I got 50 pound braided line on here, a 40 pound monofilament Carolina rig. You guys are gonna have to forgive me for the poor audio quality. Like I said, this is a dam and there's turbines over here. That's probably what you're hearing. I'm not certain on the size of hook I'm using. Okay, so I'm gonna take my bluegill and I'm gonna hook it right below the spine here. That will still allow it to swim. Let's turn around and get casted. Okay, we got that first one casted out. It's gonna be really hard to fish today. This current is crazy. We're gonna do the same thing with the second bluegill. Like I said, it's gonna be pretty hard to fish today because the current is so insane, but we're gonna do our best. I guess we'll just wait till the pole's doing a full fucking 180. Because even just right now, they're just bouncing from the current. Alright guys, look at this shit. I'm sitting here thinking like, man, that shoe feels funny. So I take it off, I'm feeling the inside, and I'm like, wow, I feel something in there. I try to pull it out, it's not coming out. Dude. You gotta be careful at the river, man. I need to get some boots. You guys be careful. It's just so hard to tell what's going on with all this fucking current. Let me get you guys closer. Well, as you can imagine, with current like this, my poles just bend. Whole time they bounce and jig and jerk, versus if the water was dead calm when that happened, I would assume I had a fish or a bite, but it's just really hard to tell with the wind and the current, on top of the fact that I have a live bluegill. So I guess timing's gonna be everything today. Alright you guys, it's calmed down a little bit, so the fishing poles are, they're pretty stable now. So now when it bounces, I assume that's either occasional, like a rough flow or a bite. The other people that were fishing here just left. I obviously was gonna respect them because they were here first. About to reel in and recast out where the hot spots are here. Oh my god, you guys, I caught a fucking gar. I caught my first fucking gar ever. Woo! Holy shit. Caught my first gar ever. Now, I think he swallowed the hook. Look at that. What a fish. I'm gonna get that line cut. Hold him up. I'm gonna see if we can help him out. I doubt it, but we're gonna see if we can help this gar out. Come on, buddy, let me in there. He's not budging at all, guys. All right, I'm just gonna have to snip it. Okay, there it is. My first ever garfish. Crazy spotted gar. Let's get him back in there. That's awesome. I'm gonna get this other one reeled in and get this one recast back out. All right, you guys, I'm fucking pissed. I just checked the footage on that gar. It is total fucking ass cheeks, and I really wanna fucking shoot myself right now, so I'm gonna apologize right now for how shitty that fucking footage is. It was zoomed in, but you know what? I did what I could. Let's try and catch something else. Casting them so close together like that with the current and the fact that they're both braided line, big risks, big rewards. Let's do it. Well, I just caught another fucking gar on a crankbait, got it to the fucking bank. I was trying to flip it and it gave me one last good flick and snapped my line and swam off with my fucking lure within arm's reach. For those of you who see my last video where I almost broke my fucking pole because I lost that catfish, I'm about twice as mad as that. The reason for that is on the last fucking gar I caught, which was my first gar ever, my camera got all fucked up. I didn't even get a good fucking shot. And now I catch another gar, the second gar I've ever caught, on a crankbait nonetheless, and it fucking snapped my 20-pound spider wire. All right, you guys, I've lost probably $25 worth of tackle today, and I'm calling it. It's fucking hot, I'm drenched in sweat, and I just keep getting fucking snags here in this fucking anarchy. I caught two gar. I was only able to get one in. I got the other one right here on the bank, and as soon as I went to flip it so I could grab it, it broke the line. Caught something new today, so that was fun. I see a turtle. Last time I was here, I caught a soft shell like that big. But I appreciate you guys sticking around to the end of the video. Hopefully next time we can get that catfish we're looking for. But until then, keep it real. Peace.